Hey guys, welcome to my channel. So my name is Miracle and I'm actually new to this whole YouTube thing, but I'm trying to experience and see what it's like or whatever, so bear with me. So yeah, on my channel you'll see vlogs, you'll see Q&A's, you're gonna see pranks, you're gonna see challenges, you know, some by myself, some of my friends. Oh, I also have a son, so we'll be doing like little arts and crafts, things like that. Maybe soon I'll do like reaction videos, but
oh no, that's just a maybe.
Sorry if you hear talking out there, that's my son and my
granddad. Yeah, they're talking out loud, so don't mind that in the background.
So yeah, I'm just, like I said, I'm just trying to experience this
YouTube thing and see what it's all about, see if I, you know, like it or whatever, and I don't know. So, yeah.
So I'm just gonna do a little, like, Q&A type thing, or not Q&A, 21 questions thing. I wrote them down on a piece of paper because I'm currently using my phone to record, so I couldn't type them
on my phone, if that makes sense. But, maybe soon I will buy a camera.
That way I can use my phone. Like, I can record from the camera and use my phone and nothing else.
I don't know yet. Anyway.
Let's just get right to the questions. And don't forget that if you like this video, to give it a big old thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And, yeah.
So, we're going to start with the first
question. Oh, my God. Can you see that? Oh, okay. You guys can see it. But I'm going to read it anyway. All right, so the first question is, what is your favorite childhood memory? All right, so for me, my favorite childhood memory is probably when I went to Disney World. Yeah, definitely when I went to Disney World.
Because,
that was my first time going on a plane. I think that was my first time going to
Florida.
I got to leave fourth grade for a whole week to go on vacation. It was nice, you know, with my godmom and stuff like that. So, yeah, that's my favorite childhood memory, is taking that vacation to,
taking that vacation to
Disney
World. Question 2.
What is your biggest regret?
My biggest regret?
I have a couple of them. I mean, nobody's perfect. We all have, you know, we make mistakes, right? But my biggest regret is not going to college. That would be my biggest regret, and the reason being is that when I was in high school, I didn't really have a favorite subject, but I knew that I wanted to go to college. I knew that I wanted to play basketball. I knew that I wanted to do different things. It's just that I doubted myself a lot, I guess. So me doubting myself resulted in me not going.
Like, I graduated,
but then I had ended up having my child like a few months after graduation or whatever. So
I never went to college, and
if I could, I would rewind and go back and do that. So, if you're in high school and you're watching this, go to college. Go to college, okay? I'm telling you, because you're gonna be like me, graduated, you know, 2-3 years ago, whatever. Actually, I graduated. Oh my God,
I'm getting old. I graduated 4 years ago.
Okay, anyway, you're gonna be like me. You're gonna graduate, and you're gonna go, damn, I wish I would have done this and done this and nothing like that. So,
go to college. Stay in school. Yeah.
Alright, question 3.
What is the last book you read?
Honestly, I'm not a reading person. I haven't read a book in a long time. I actually use my,
my iBooks, like on my
phone. And there's a book on there. I don't even remember what the name is. That's the crazy part, because I haven't read it in a while. But.
So, I'm sorry, guys, I don't remember.
Do you prefer kissing or cuddling?
I'm going to keep this
as PG as possible. I prefer none, okay? Kissing and cuddling leads to babies, okay? Remember that. Kissing, cuddling, babies. You don't want no babies right now. You're too young. If you're young and you're watching this, don't even worry about that, because y'all not going to be kissing and cuddling and all that. Y'all ain't going to be doing that, so don't worry about that. For the growner people, for me,
I don't know, it depends.
If the person is a good kisser, then definitely I'd say kissing.
And if that person's not a good kisser, it should be cuddling, I guess. By the way, I did not choose these questions. I actually had a friend help me pick out these questions. So, yeah. Alright, question 5. Who is the first person you call when something horrible happens? The police. Like, no. When something bad or horrible happens, it depends. If it's like life or death matter horrible, I definitely call my grandmother.
Yeah, I definitely call my grandmother.
But if it's like horrible, but like it can be fixable.
Then, I don't know, I call, I'm sorry.
I call one of like my best friends, my close friend. He knows who he is, so there's no point in even doing all that. But yeah, he knows.
Question 6.
What is the one item you can't leave home without? That's a no-brainer. As a matter of fact, I got it right here.
This bad boy?
Never will you catch me without it. Why? I don't know. I've always liked Carmex, okay? I just love this stuff. If you know me personally, then you know Carmex is my favorite freaking thing to have all the time. So that being said, like, I found myself often buying, like, more than one. And then I'll end up, like, opening, like, 3. So then I keep one at home, one in my car, one at work. I don't know, one in my bag for if I go somewhere. Like, I have a bunch of those. And I have, like, a bunch of my dresser. I just keep them just in case, and I just love them, so... Yeah, you will never catch me. And if there is ever a day that I go somewhere and I do forget it, bro, I will go to the store and I'll buy another one. Because I love that. I love that stuff. I just love it. I don't know. What do you do? Question 7.
Who has left the most
impact on your life? That's another no-brainer. Definitely my son. Because... Before I had my son, I'm not going to say I was a wild child. Well, actually, okay, I was a wild child. I was bad. I don't care. I was bad. But not even that. When I was younger, I was like, oh, I'm never going to have kids. Oh, I'm not going to have kids. Yada, yada. We all say that, whatever. But before I had my son, I let the freedom of being 18, like, get to my head. And I was, like, doing not wild stuff, but, you know, partying, whatever, whatever. Just doing whatever I want to do. So now my son, I calmed down a lot and I got my shit together, like a lot, compared to back then, a lot. So I would definitely say my son has a big impact on my life, big, big, big impact. All right, question 8, what do you consider unforgivable? This one was kind of hard because like, there's a lot of things that people do that you would say, oh, I can't forgive you. I can't forgive you. Oh, I'm never going to forgive you. Oh, I'm going to hold a grudge forever. No, but from. Okay. So, honestly, for me,
it's unforgivable for me.
Probably putting your hands on a woman, like a man putting his hands on a woman type of thing, that's unacceptable. I couldn't forget. I mean, I've had, you know, guys put their hands on me before, and I've forgiven them. But trust me, it never happened again. You know what I'm saying? But, like, I don't know. That's a hard question, because cheating's unforgivable.
There's a lot of things that are
unforgivable. I don't know, but it's something about when a man puts his hands on a woman. It's like, how? You know what I'm saying? But we all make mistakes, so. It's a little harder, but... Question 9. What is the first app you check when you wake up in the morning?
Honestly,
when I first wake up, I read whatever notifications like are on my lock screen, but I don't actually, for some reason, I never open my text first thing in the morning. I just don't. If somebody texts me and I see it the next morning and it's somebody that normally does text me, then in my head, I'm just like, all right, like, I kind of know what they're going to say type of thing, I guess. But when it's, like, somebody that never pops on my phone early in the morning, I'm just like, oh, maybe it's something important. Let me read it. But other than that, when I first open my phone,
First thing I check is my bank account, and what's the other thing? Bank account, and I always say my bank account, my Snapchat. I don't really get on my phone in the mornings because, like, when I get up, I'm like, you know what I'm saying, get my son ready for school, I'm getting ready for work, or whatever the case may be. So I don't really be on my phone much in the morning. But the reason why I check those two is because my bank be playing with me, y'all. I have Capital One, okay, and they be playing with me sometimes because, like, they'll take money out of my account, and they'll take money out of my account. Oh, my bad. They'll take money out of my account and say that I made a purchase or something. But then I'll put the money right back, and then it won't be there. Like, the transaction won't be there, and I'm just like, sorry. I'm like, what the heck, okay? So I check that just to make sure, you know, they ain't playing with me. And then my Snapchat, I check that because people, I don't know why, but people tend to get irritated when I Snapchat back late. But it's not even that. Like, y'all Snapchat me at, like, 3 in the damn morning, and I gotta be up at 7 in the morning. I'm not about to be on Snapchat all night. No, I'll check it when I check it. So sometimes I check it in the morning so I can reply to that person so they don't feel like, damn, I just carried them the whole day. So, yeah, those are the main two. Yeah, those are pretty much the main two. Question 10. What is thumb or one of your bad habits? That's easy. One of my bad habits is, actually, I have two bad habits. One of them is biting my nails. Boy, let me tell you. I bite my nails a lot. I try not to, but it's a habit. Whatever. So I try to, like, keep acrylics on because, like, obviously they're plastic, so I can't chew them, and it kind of helps. And then my other habit is, like, I'll be talking about something with somebody, and then I'll get distracted, and that'll move to the next subject, and then another subject, and another subject, and then I'm going back to the other subject. Like, that's a bad thing. Like, I get distracted with anything. All right, question 11. What is your most commonly used swear word?
Okay, so
I do not condone cursing. I don't condone bad language. It doesn't matter if you've grown, not grown. I don't condone it, so to say. But if you do it, it's your life. You know what I'm saying? I curse. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to say it's a habit because everybody curses. But anyway, I think my biggest curse word that I use is probably the
F-bomb. I drop the F-bomb a lot.
Or the MF-bomb. I drop both of those bombs a lot. I say those curse words a lot. And it's not a good thing. It's not funny. It's not cute. Whatever. But, like, it's not one of those things where, like, if I'm having a conversation, I could have a conversation without cursing. You know what I'm saying? But there might be times where I'm, like, really mad. I'm like, what am I, like? You know what I'm saying? I don't know. Especially when I'm driving. I have bad road rage. Y'all don't want to drive with me because I'll be cursing if it's going. I don't care.
Question 12.
When was the first time you were on a plane? The first time I was on a plane was the last time I was on a plane, which was when I went to Florida in fourth grade. Yeah, I was nervous as heck. Come on, though. I was nervous as heck. And I didn't know what to do. Honestly, I just had so many, like, worries that we weren't going to make it or whatever, but obviously we did. But, yeah, that was my first and my last time on a plane back in fourth grade.
Question 13.
Oh, I just dropped my question.
Question 13.
What is my height? I'm short, y'all. I'm only 4'11". Okay? 4'11". I'm 4'11". I'm really short. I've probably been this height since I was in, like, fifth grade for a little. I've been short all my life, and it's from my mom's side of family because, like, my mom is only, like, 5'5". And then my grandma's about, like, I don't know, 5'7", 5'8". All my females in my family, they're really short, so whatever.
I deal with it.
Question 14. What is your favorite drink?
That is so easy for me. If you know me personally, y'all know all I drink is Coca-Cola. And
right now I'm trying to like cut back from it because I'm breaking out. Okay, well, I'm trying to cut back from it because I don't like. Like, I love Coca-Cola, but I hate when I break out, man. I be sitting here like, oh my God, I'm breaking out. But then, like, I'll leave and then go right to the store or, like, to McDonald's and get another Coke. And I just drop my questions again. My bad, y'all. So, that's the favorite drink one. So, yeah, Coca-Cola was my favorite drink. Okay?
Or is my favorite drink. Question 15.
What is my favorite TV show or shows? I have two main favorite TV shows.
The first one is
Black Ink Crew, Chicago and New York. But New York is mainly my favorite show. Black Ink. Yeah, Black Ink. New York. Yeah, that's my favorite show. And then my other, like, number one favorite. Well, actually. Gosh, that. I have three favorite shows. Forensic Files. I don't know if y'all know about that, but. Forensic Files. I've been watching like Discovery shows, like crime shows and stuff like that for years. Okay, me and my granddad. I remember like every Saturday we used to sit up there and watch America's Most Wanted. I don't know if y'all remember that show, but we used to watch that all the time. So I've just always liked those shows. So Forensic Files, Law and Order SVU. I love me some Olivia. Like I just love her. I don't know her real name, but I just love her. I just know her as Olivia Benson on the show. Anyway, no. So, yeah, Forensic Files, Black Ink, and SVU. Those are my three favorite shows. Question 16. Are you single or taken? Single, but I know a couple is gonna be mad when I answer. It's like, nah. I am currently single. I'm not really ready for a relationship right now. I mean, because I'm still trying to figure out my life, and for me, it would be hard to maintain a relationship, so I'm not in a relationship right now. Do I, you know, have somebody in potential mind? Kind of, sort of, like, we have a bond, we go way back, whatever the case may be, but I don't consider that a relationship, but, I mean, he knows, and I know, and, again, I'm not worried about it, he's not worried about it, so, whatever. But, technically, yes, I am single. Question 17. Do you have siblings? Yes, I do. I have two little brothers. I have two little brothers. One name is Nate, and the other one's name is Mikey. Mikey is getting ready to be 16. Yeah, Mikey's getting ready to be 16. And then my other brother, Nate, he's getting ready to be
20. Yeah, you're getting ready to be 20.
So I have a 16-year-old brother and a 20-year-old brother. Well, almost 20 and almost 16-year-old brothers. So they getting big, they getting grown.
But whatever.
Question 18. What is your birthday or age or my sign or all that together, I guess? So my birthday is August 8th. 8-8. I am a Leo, gang gang. And I am 21. You better be 22 in August, obviously, but yeah. Shout out to all my Leos, all the August babies, all the 21-year-olds, gang.
And yeah.
Question 19. What is the farthest you've been from home? Farthest I've been from home is Florida. I went to Florida a couple times, actually. I went to Florida the first time in fourth grade. I went to, what was it called? Walt Disney World or whatever. Then I went a couple years back, we went to like Kissimmee, Florida, SeaWorld and stuff like that. The first time we took a the first time we were in a plane, the second time I went, we drove. I'd rather have been on that plane, because that was the longest drive of my life. Y'all don't understand, my butt was numb, it was hot. And then at that time my son was about about 4 months old, 5 months old, so he's cranky. That it was like 17 hours drive, girl. I was like, God. My son's godma went with us, and I know she was baking too. It was hot. It was hot that day. It was hot that whole trip. It was the worst traveling experience for me, but when I got there, it was definitely relaxing. But so the farthest I've been from home is Florida twice. Yes.
So far, yet to come.
All right, question 20. What do you hope never changes?
Now, when I got asked this
question, I honestly didn't know how to answer it. Like, I was so confused as far as, like, in what sense or whatever. But it took some thinking. I'm not gonna lie. It took some thinking. But the one thing that I hope, like, never, ever, 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 ever,
ever
changes is, like, the bond that I have with my grandma. Me and my grandma, like, we've been close ever since I can remember. She's always been my mother figure. So, yeah, like, she's definitely, been the one that's been there for me through everything, through
school, through concerts,
through, having my son, through graduation, through, she taught me how to drive, she helped me get my license, she helped raise me, my brothers, my son, a various amount of my cousins and stuff. Like, so the one thing that I hope never changes is the bond that me and my grandmother have, and I doubt that would ever happen, but you never know. So that's the one thing that I hope never changes. But,
last but not least,
question 21. What is the one thing that you want that you can't afford?
I want a Ferrari,
a little Lamborghini, I want a mansion, No. Alright, so for real. The one thing that I want that I cannot afford is a Hummer. Ever since I was a kid, I've been obsessed with Hummers forever. I don't know why. Just have.
Back then, I really
was, like, obsessed with the color pink, so I really wanted a pink one. But now, as an adult, I just want a Hummer. I don't even care what color it is, that's what I want. So that's the one thing that I want that I can't afford, but who knows, y'all might see me strolling around here one day in a Hummer. So, I can't afford
it right now, but maybe one day I will be able to do it.
Maybe one day.
Maybe. Yeah, guys, so that's
it. There's more to come, more to come. This is just like a little intro, kind of for me to get my little confidence up, whatever. Because if you know me personally, and if you're watching this, y'all know it took a lot for me to do this, okay? A lot. But I did it. So yeah, there's more to come. I'll try to post as much as I can. I do have like a regular, like 9 to 5, so it's going to be a little bit hard. But I'm going to do my best. I'm going to do my best. Anyways, like I said, don't forget to like and subscribe this if you choose to. And then, you know, follow me on Snapchat. My Snapchat will be listed. And follow me on Instagram as well.
And yeah. Thanks for watching, guys.